Your teenage daughters and their lonely math tutors know our next guest as Civil War soldier turned vegetarian vampire Jasper Hale in the hugely popular Twilight movies. The latest installment, Breaking Dawn Part 1, opens the theaters Friday. Please welcome Jackson Rathbone. And she has a migraine headache.
She's got a migraine.
Yeah, all the screaming has been very bad for her.
I am so sorry. I won't scream. I was planning on. I was really excited to be here with Jimmy, so I was going to give a screech.
Okay, you're feeling better now? Just go along with it.
Better.
She's not. You were supposed to be here with the whole Twilight cast last year, but at the last minute something happened. You weren't able to come.
I'm so sorry. I'm a huge fan, Jimmy.
And thank you.
It really kind of hurt me that I couldn't come out here. And it was literally a pain that in my mouth. I had my wisdom tooth finally kind of emerged. And I've been doing press the entire week, and so I was sitting there kind of like this during a lot of my interviews. And eventually I was like, I can't do it, man, I can't do it. So I had to go to the doctor, have it ripped out of my face.
You did.
And, yeah.
Was it bad?
It was bad. It was completely out. And the doctor was like, oh, this isn't too bad. I was kind of pop it out there. I hate dentists. I hadn't been to the dentist in 5 years.
Well, that's probably why you hate them, yeah.
Yeah. But, you know, I actually... I brought one. I brought the tooth for you.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Really?
I wanted proof. I wanted to prove to you that this is actually... This is
a vampire tooth. Yeah. If it pokes me, I could be among the undead.
Okay.
Well, this is... I will cherish this. Can I sell this on eBay?
Yes.
Yes? Yeah. Thank you very much. That's now, you've been all over promoting the movie. Where have you been so far in the last week?
Oh man, it's been insane. I was in Madrid in Spain, which is beautiful. I was in Rome in Italy, which is my mother's favorite country, and city. So that was beautiful. You can feel the history.
Nice. And do you get to go to do anything while you're there, or are you just zipping through?
You're just zipping through. We had 30 minutes to see the Colosseum. 30
That's
minutes.
That's enough.
Yeah. Really. You know, I saw the entire thing, got the entire history lesson. It was beautiful.
You're in a band too, I know. Is it? And have you? Band, apparently.
Yeah. There's a woman with a headache here.
Are they cheering?
They're sadists.
Well, you go on the road with the band? Do you travel around with them, too?
Yeah, we travel all the time. We've been on a couple tours now. We're actually about to head to Europe for our first European tour, November 26th. And it's wild, man. It's completely different than doing the press for the films. And the press for the films, it's kind of luxurious. They put us up in these nice hotels.
Right.
It's nice. With the band, it's staying in Motel 6s.
Is it really?
Yeah, it's pretty gnarly. It's pretty gnarly. But occasionally, you know, we can go out to a pub or a bar, and I'm kind of a whiskey guy. And there's this... we got some whiskey screamers. Yeah, I love it. But we were in this bar in Gainesville, Florida. And it was called Mother's Whiskey Bar. And this guy, the server, had a shirt that said Mother's Whiskey Boy. And I was like, oh, I want that. That's nice. And I asked him, I was like, oh, how much is the shirt? And he's like, oh, you can't buy it. You actually got to do the 14-shot whiskey challenge.
Oh, really?
Most people have a week to do this. I'm like, oh, 14 shots in a week, that's nothing. Come on.
Yeah.
But after the show, my buddy Ben and I went to the bar, and we had 30 minutes. 30 minutes to do 14 shots.
And?
And, well, there's the 18-year, there's the 12-year, there's some blends, and then there's that dirty jack shot, you know. And so we're about 5 left into it, and that's kind of when everything faded away. Is that how you put it? And then suddenly you just don't remember anything except waking up in a dark alley in the rain.
Did you really wake up in the rain?
I woke up in the rain. I was like freezing. I was sitting there shivering. I woke up. I was like, where am I? What's happening? Why am I wet? Okay. And then I called my friend on my phone, which I cracked, which is like that nice, like nice new, brand new crack.
Nice.
In it. I call my tour manager. I'm like, hey, I'm stuck in this dark alley. I have no idea where Ben is. I don't know what's happening.
Ben was your buddy that was with you?
Oh. We were drinking together.
Nice.
No idea where he is. It's kind of one of those hangover moments.
Uh-huh.
So my buddy picks me up, takes me back to the hotel, and like I kind of, you know, like sleep it off in the car. Because they won't let me in the hotel room. They're like, okay, well, you deserve to sleep in the car.
Right.
You bastard. And so I wake up the next morning, everybody's so angry at us, and we still don't know where Ben is. It's like literally, we have no idea where he is. And I'm apologizing, I'm you know, praying, you know, like, please let us find Ben. And then finally we get this call from a payphone, and they just had some motel down the street, so we go to pick him up, and everybody's just been so angry, everybody's angry, pissed off. And he runs out with this big old smile on his face. He's like, we got the shirts, man.
Oh, yeah.
We got them. We did the challenge.
Which one of these guys is Ben?
Oh, that's him. That's him right
here.
That's
Ben? Yeah, I would have guessed that. And who's the guy in the middle?
This, ladies and gentlemen, this is Master Lawrence Abrams. Also referred to as Uncle Larry. That's Uncle Larry? Yeah?
How did Uncle Larry wind up? Whose uncle is he in this group? Because how did Uncle Larry wind up with you?
Well, I mean,
he looks a little bit older than you.
Just a little. well, basically, you know, Lawrence came to us. You know, he calls himself Uncle Larry because it stands for UL, you know, Universal Love, as he says.
Okay.
And he's just one of those guys. It's just so amazing. He adds that sage wisdom, that amazing advice. And
What advice has he given you?
What advice is to get? Yeah. Never do a 14-shot whiskey challenge while in the middle of a tour. Unfortunately, that advice came a little late.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations on all your success. What's the name of your band? We haven't mentioned the name of the band.
100 Monkeys.
100 Monkeys.
Jackson Rathbone, everybody.